somebody called out to me how many minutes do I have? We need to break this fast, because I do not want to be invited here for the first time.
Seven minutes.
Flag me at 6 a.m. I am so serious about this. First of all, let me just say that I am blessed and feeling really favored to have been invited here tonight. I enjoy the company of some new friends and some longtime friends, and I enjoy the opportunity of celebrating the diversity of the 12th Congressional District. I, like you, have come tonight with a heavy heart. I know how painful it is to have experienced what we experienced when we woke up this morning. That some single individual who never should have had access to any kind of a weapon was able to negatively impact 103 people. 50 died, but 53 others were also injured. But I'm also heartbroken because a 16-year-old was killed in the city of Trenton. And just last week or the week before, 64 people were killed or shot and were shot in the city of Chicago. And when we wake up every single solitary day and we experience the kind of devastation that guns have on our community. And it's enough. It is enough for us to stand up together and to use the will that we have to be able to come together as communities to make sure that everybody that we know gets out and registers and votes, not vote for Bonnie Watson only, but please do, but vote because you want to send a message that we are tired of having fear in our communities. We are tired of having discrimination in our communities. Discrimination is not just against the Muslim community. It is against women. It is against the LGBT community. It is against the African American community. It is anti-Semitic bigotry that takes place every single solitary day. This country that was founded on freedom, the freedom to congregate, the freedom to assemble, the freedom to speak, the freedom to worship, the freedom from persecution, is being challenged today unlike it's ever been before in my lifetime. And you can look at the so-called wisdom on my forehead, on my head, and know that I've been around a while. But this is also, while it represents a challenge, it represents an opportunity. It represents for all good people to get up together and to say enough is enough, and we'll not tolerate this in our communities anymore. Last night was just a horrible, horrible experience for anybody that understands that our religious beliefs are based upon tolerance and love and kindness and meekness and sharing and generosity. That's in my Bible, that's in the Quran, and that's in the Torah. We share those values, and we are the majority of the people. So we need to use the fact that we are the majority of the people and be able to push back on the hatred and on the disgusting display of Islamophobia and xenophobia and misogyny and anti-Semitism and racism and say, this country belongs to every one of us. This country was founded by immigrants. This is a country of immigrants. And we deserve to be treated with the same dignity and respect as anybody else. But unless we get up, and unless we let our voices be heard when we peacefully demonstrate, be heard when we're in our houses of worship and we're speaking. Be heard when we write our letters to the newspaper. But mostly be heard when we go to the polls and we vote for the people who we are holding accountable. We shouldn't give up our vote and we shouldn't take our vote for granted. We need to stand up and ask these individuals who are seeking our vote, where do you stand on our issues? Where do you stand on mental health issues? Where do you stand on gun safety issues? Where do you stand on a woman's rights? Where do you stand on the LGBT community? Where do you stand on your respect for the diversity of our communities? And if they answer the way that we want them to answer, then we should support them and vote for them. And if they don't, we should reject their candidacies. Because this is not a country that will survive on hate and disgust and treating just the 1 or 0.1%. We have a responsibility to be our sisters' keepers and our brothers' keepers. And I know that as we represent the majority of the world and that love is at the core of our being, that we will do this together. I've just got the 1 minute. Thank you and God bless.